All right, guys, I got this little product to open up and test out or look through it and see if it's any good. This is the Zombie Apocalypse Survival Kit in a sardine can. We're going to go ahead and open it up and see what's actually in it. See if it would actually help you in a bug out or zombie apocalypse type situation. We'll get it out of the plastic wrap here. Give me one second. And the can itself, it is just basically a little sardine can. Tells you a little bit of information. If you guys want to pause, you might be able to read what's in there. We're just going to go ahead and take everything out and just look at it, so I'm not going to bother reading that. So let's go ahead, see what we got in here and see what they could be used for. Alright, here on top it looks like this is almost like little instructions. It says this survival kit contains more than 25 items, and here are some items. So it looks like, first off, with the little instruction tab pad there, it also has some things and a plastic bag, which you can use a plastic bag for storing even water or something. So let's see what all this is. We have some duct tape. This is not very much duct tape, but it's something. You know, duct tape's always useful, so it's good that it's in there. This is a very small amount, though. Let's see what these are. We have a alcohol prep pad. Just kind of put the items around. Here we have Amiphone. I guess this is acetaminophen or whatever. This is like a Tylenol. Here is antibacterial ointment. I put on band-aids. And then we have a Lipton tea salt packet. And then a standard pack of matches. Nothing special, but a standard pack of matches. Definitely need matches to light fires. And then it looks like this is just kind of, this might be a little, okay, it's a little thing. It's got some first aid information and treatment of certain things, and it's got a, it's kind of, this is water purification and some other information on here. So nothing amazing here, but a little bit of stuff to read and maybe help you out. Paperclip, could find some use for that. Also, safety pin. Let's see what else we got in here. Tootsie Roll, and it's a little bit of sugar and energy. You got sugar to add to your tea there. You got a piece of Wrigley's gum, and I think this is Big Red, yeah. Big Red gum, one piece. Just one Band-Aid, it looks like. I'm amazed there's not more than just one Band-Aid, but just one Band-Aid. Here we have some thread. It's fairly thin, but it's not like super thin. You could probably even use this as fishing line, unless they gave us some fishing line in here. I don't know if they gave us any fishing hooks either. Yes, they did. And there's one little fishing hook, which would be good for bluegill and such, which you can actually eat bluegill. They're actually really good. So you could catch a lot of bluegill with this thread and this little fishing hook. Use something for bait, little insects, or you could find worms somewhere. Little razor. Should be able to take that out. Well, no real point to take it out, but little flat razor. Little piece of fire starter tinder. You can cut this up with your razor and, you know, have a little bit of tinder to start a fire. You don't have to probably use the whole thing at once. What is this? Oh, little compass. I don't know if you guys can see this on camera because it's kind of dark over here, but it's a little compass. So that could come in handy if you're walking somewhere. You want to make sure you keep going the same direction. If you want to keep going in a straight line somewhere, could definitely come in handy. And then a whistle. I don't want to blow it too hard and make the microphone like scream at you guys or the speaker scream at you, but it definitely was about to work there. I just don't want to make that too loud for you guys. And then just a pen. Pencil. No little pad of paper to write on. I've had one of these kits before, and it had some other items. It had some fishing line. It had a couple different items. More metal, like metal twine that you could use for making snares and such. This doesn't have that. It looks like this kit, pretty much all you're going to be able to do is walk in a straight line, write something. You can make a fire or two with your matches. You can cook some fish inside this sardine pan. You get a couple bluegill, you can cut them up, fillet them, and you can cook your fillets in here on a fire. Then you just have a little bit of tea and a little bit of first aid. So there's really not much in here for making traps or anything. Like I said, some of the other ones have like metal wire stuff where you can make snares and stuff, catch little animals. This one doesn't have anything like that. It's basically you're going to fish and you're going to be able to make a fire, and that's about it. So if you need to catch some bluegill and you need to survive off bluegill for a few days, and there's a pond nearby or a lake nearby, which you're going to need to be nearby, then you might be able to live for a little bit off this kit until you lose that hook or something. But bluegill are pretty easy to catch without losing hooks usually. So that's what's in the kit. Just wanted to go ahead and open it up and show you guys what's in there and take a look for myself. So if you have any questions, let me know. We'll see you guys all later.